And we talked about induction and patterning of mesoderm in Xenopus. So we talked about how the different experiments that demonstrate that mesoderm is actually induced by communication between animal cap cells and vegetal whole cells. And we defined some terms, cell autonomous versus non-cell autonomous. So a cell autonomous effect would be, for example, a mutation in a gene in the animal cells that affects mesoderm induction. If it's mutated, it affects that animal cell from becoming mesoderm. Whereas a non-cell autonomous effect would be a mutation in the vegetal cell, for example, that has to signal to the animal cell, cap cell, to become mesoderm. That, because it's a mutation in one cell that affects another cell's fate, that's a non-cell autonomous effect. Okay, and then we talked about, in Xenopus, about this four-signal model of how mesoderm is induced and how it's patterned into dorsal mesoderm, lateral mesoderm, and ventral mesoderm. And so the first induction of mesoderm occurs when vegetal cells interact with animal cap cells by secreting factors that induce mesoderm in the cells right above the vegetal hole. The second signal for mesoderm induction comes from the meatloop center to help organize or help arrange the embryo so that it has a clear dorsal side versus ventral side. And then there are signals from the organizer region that inhibit expression of certain signaling pathways like Wnt inhibitors, for example. And those expression of those genes just in the organizer region begins to pattern the embryo from the dorsal side towards the ventral side. And then you start to get your mesoderm induced into different compartments. And from our fate maps and specification maps, we know that the different parts of the mesoderm, so the dorsal mesoderm versus the ventral mesoderm, can develop into eventually different tissue types. So their location in the embryo is important, and so they need to be patterned early on so that the more mature animal will have all of its parts. Okay, so in the full mesoderm four signal model, there's both maternal and zygotic genes involved. And almost all the signaling pathways that we've discussed thus far are also involved in patterning the mesoderm. So TGF-beta, Wnt, nodal, BMP, FGF should be somewhat familiar with these signaling pathways in terms of what their function is in mesoderm. Okay, so I just mentioned how dorsal ventral patterning of mesoderm occurs. It's basically by regulating signaling pathways in the dorsal versus the ventral parts of the embryo, and this results in specific expression of particular genes in different areas of the mesoderm. And we talked about how the concentration, or the relative concentration, of these signaling proteins in the dorsal versus ventral sides helps cement that dorsal and ventral pattern. Okay, so what we're going to do today is finish up the discussion of mesoderm induction. We're going to talk about now the same concepts, but in the chick and the mouse. And then we'll go into the next lecture where we talk about somite formation. Okay, so you will recall in the chick and the mouse that mesoderm induction occurs in an area of the embryo called the primitive streak. Okay, so just to review from previous lectures, I by another group of cells called the endoblast. And at gastrulation, you see the structure called the primitive streak that emerges from the section of the embryo called the posterior marginal zone. And if you look at embryos at this stage, you will see this kind of gray or kind of pointed structure on the embryos that connects the primitive streak. The primitive streak helps determine the posterior side of the embryo, so it sets up the posterior and anterior axis. And as we'll see, it also helps to determine the ventral side of the dorsal ventral axis. And the primitive streak is the site through which, it's basically a strip of cells through which other cells will pass through during gastrulation. And so it's a very active developmental site in the chamber. So this is a three-dimensional picture of the chick embryo that shows you the primitive streak. It's kind of like a cavern. Okay, so this is the, here you see the epiblast cells kind of shown in blue. The primitive streak contains mainly mesodermal cells that's shown more in like the pinkish. And the cells are actively migrating into the interior of the embryo. And as we'll talk about later in the lecture, the mesoderm is the main tissue from which somites form. And I'll tell you what somites are in a few more slides. Okay, the other structure that you should be familiar with in the chick is this part here called Ensign's node. It's basically is this region of cells that is formed at the end of the primitive streak, and then at a certain stage of development, mostly after gastrulation, this group of tissue and the cells near it will migrate back towards the posterior end. And so Ensign's node is an organizing tissue. As it migrates, it induces the formation of different mesodermal tissues along the anterior and posterior axis. Okay, and that's shown here. And so I've shown you this slide before when we were just kind of introducing the chick embryo. So now I'm reintroducing it to you in terms of mesodermal induction. Okay, so this is the embryo. Now we're looking at it from the top. You see Ensign's node is depicted here as this red circle, and this is the primitive streak. So Ensign's node will migrate from the anterior to the posterior of the embryo with time. And as it migrates, the tissue that is left behind in the more anterior region will be induced to develop into more complex structures. So for example, we start to see here the development of the head fold and the anterior end. And at later stages, we see the development of what are called somites, which are the blocks of tissue that become the muscle, as well as help to define where the vertebrae will be in the mature embryo. Okay, so if we want to look at where the mesodermal tissue is in the chick embryo at different stages, we can use our handy-dandy tool, immunohistochemistry, and stain for transcription factors that are known to be expressed only in mesodermal tissue. And one of the main key mesodermal identifying proteins is one called brachyuria. And so that's shown here in brown. So at the 13 somite stain, you see that only the tissue that is present kind of where the primitive streak